So today, I was supposed to release a video about how Drag Race loves to have a token weird queen each season that, most of the time, they try to bury while uplifting a more Ru-loved style of drag, and all of the implications that that can have on an audience that usually only knows about drag through Drag Race, but that also sadly cannot comprehend that Drag Race is not the only type of drag or drag-related avenue. But then I released that video about the weird edit that Crystal got on season 3 of Drag Race UK. I saw that half of the comments legitimately did not even watch the video, or even worse, watched it but then just chose not to listen or twist my words. So I just said, yeah, I'm not going through that nonsense again. I mean, listen, you might see this previously mentioned video idea on my Patreon, like exclusively on there, or on a copycat channels where they will just regurgitate what I have said or what the majority of the fandom has said, but hey, let me give them a challenge. Please copy this video. To quote Ashley Tisdale, show me some positivity. But not COVID positivity. Get vaccinated and wear a mask, please. I will be saying something nice about every queen that competed on Drag Race seasons 12 and 13, UK seasons 1, 2, and 3, and Drag Race España. Why not any other season? Well, there are two possible answers to that. One is that I hate all of them and it's my mission in life to ruin them. Or, and get this, I have not watched those seasons. I wonder which one out of those two it is. This video will not be scripted, so if some sentences don't sound comprehensive, yeah, that's why. Before I begin, let me give a Patron shoutout to my new patron this week, Armin. Thank you for joining and thank you for helping me out. I will be doing these in the order of elimination, so here we're starting with Dahlia Sin. Now, it's been a hot minute since I watched season 12, and it's a season that we can't really properly talk about without mentioning the fact that it had to be quickly re-edited with the whole Sherry Pie scandal, so it's all a bit blurry to me. However, Dahlia Sin, what I remember of her and what I remember liking of her is first of all her style. She has a very cool style, and also there's this whole cool vibe with her. I can't really explain it well, but she just seems like somebody you would want to hang out with. Next, Rock'em Sakura. Now, first of all, okay, trade of season 12. I won't hear anything. No, she was the hottest person on that season. Also, one of the coolest drag styles. I know it's not, let's say, the most original in the sense that many people that watch Drag Race now are probably also fans of Trixie, and when they see her, they're probably going to comment, oh no, she's just copying Trixie. She's not, like, Trixie does not own that style of drag. But Rock'em is really cool. Also, really entertaining. You guys really need to watch her channel and subscribe if you're not subscribed. You should also subscribe to me. But Rock'em, I'm disappointed in Drag Race that even then, but also still, some 12 or so years after starting the show, they don't have much respect for queens that are of East Asian or Southeast Asian descent. And by the way, this is also a topic that I wanted to cover, but as I'm not of East or Southeast Asian descent, there's some muddy aspects of, like, am I speaking over those queens and, you know, people? I'm not really speaking for them because nobody asked me to do it. You know what I mean. But hopefully we see Rock'em on an all-star season, because I think that in a more, let's say, competitive environment where she's also more appreciated, which can be all-stars, she can shine a lot more. Next up, Nicky Doll. So I'm a whore for anybody that's not from the US, but obviously will compete on a US Drag Race season. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that I really like Nicky Doll's approach to drag, where she's able to put forward the fact that she, well, is French, obviously, and just that fact makes her stand out immediately amongst this cast of queens, which sadly do tend to kind of make their drag US-centric, regardless of their ethnicities and backgrounds, but hey, that's a story for another day. I'm still trying to get over how gorgeous Nicki looked in her Cinderella-esque look, but I am glad that WOW gave her a show because she has a talent for fashion, or should I say an eye for fashion. Either way, Yeah, she's fantastic. Aiden Zhane. All right, listen. There is something kind of underdog rooting for her that I liked on season 12. I did not really get why there are a lot of queens on that season that disliked her. Maybe there was some behind-the-scenes stuff that I don't know about, but, you know, tell me if there is. Aiden's style that's, like, bordering on horror, but not really going fully there, but also that's kind of gothic, but also there is some sort of, like, simplicity to it. I like that. It's a really interesting approach to drag. Also, I'll say this. I did not have a problem with her one wig, because let's get this. Not every queen is rich and can have tens of thousands of human wigs, or not even human, but like just wigs in general. I'm fine with Aiden. Yeah. Yeah. Brita. Okay, this is a queen that needs so much love, because for some fucking reason, the fans after her stint on the show were so mean to her. I don't get why. Yes, was she edited to be like the villain or like the mini villain of that season? Yes, that did happen. And yes, that can affect certain people's vision of her. But that doesn't mean that they should hate her, because she's a ball of energy. She's fun. Why do you people hate fun? I really like Brita. Even when season 12 was airing, I liked her. I didn't have a problem with her. Also, such a gorgeous smile. How do you have so many teeth? And can I have some of them? I mean, like, my teeth are fine, but like, they can be better, like Brita's, but they're not. Stan Brita is what I'm trying to say, and don't bully her. Like, why would you do that? Okay, Jan. What I like about Jan is her dedication to what she does. There's this Rachel Berry quality to her that is kind of admirable, where she knows what she wants, she knows how she's gonna get to it, and she's not gonna stop, because people may deem that she's unlikable, or maybe neurotic, or whatever else you could say negative about that. And I think that can be admirable, as long as, of course, it doesn't go into the part where you're Leah Michelle-ing people. Yeah, very talented, a really good singer, and she has a very palatable style of drag. Mainstream audience can enjoy her, you know what I mean? Also, really pretty in and out of drag. Widow Von Du. I've been told that there were some domestic abuse charges, if I remember correctly, about her. So let me say that we're talking about Widow now as she is on the season, nothing outside of the show, which I know can also be problematic in the sense that you're ignoring things that happen off the show. It's hard to kind of figure this stuff out, so just bear with me. I want to say that Widow Von Du is a really good performer. I think that she was horribly mistreated on that season, and that the episode that she went out, she legit would have won had it been any other season that also had a political challenge. And her look for the Stars and Stripes runway, well, maybe not being the most elaborative whatever, was clever and needed on that season, and of course in that time as well. Heidi and Closet. Okay, where do I begin? First of all, my favorite queen of that season. Another thing, one of my favorite queens in the past, God knows how long, on Drag Race. There's this sort of ditziness and silliness to her that I really admire, and that I, you know, look for in people in general. It's so refreshing to see somebody who's like doing drag because it's really fun, but then they're also fun out of drag as well, so drag doesn't seem just like an alter ego or something. Like, that's still Heidi in or out of drag. That's still the same person, personality. She's really fucking fun. She's grown a lot from her season. Like, if you go to her Instagram and you see her looks now, she's fucking killing it. If she's on an all-star season, she's going to do really well on there. I have no doubts in my mind about that. What I'm trying to say is, stan Heidi in Closet. Also, do not change your name. It's a great name. The fact that RuPaul is not able to pronounce it is stupid. Love that name for her. Next up is Jackie Cox. I think that Jackie has like a diet approach to the things that she talked about regarding, let's say, well, yeah, the mistreatment of Muslim people in the US is something very needed on US television, of course. And it's a nice way to kind of lead people into that conversation without maybe going too much into like ideologies and whatnot. It's kind of like what the Spice Girls did with feminism. They were like diet feminism, like girl power that would lead you to feminism. The same way that maybe the things that Jackie Cox talked about on season 12 could lead you into understanding better just how poorly Muslim people have been treated in the US, probably even before 9/11, but especially after 9/11. So yeah, good on Jackie Cox. Her inclusion in this season was honestly necessary. Oh no, Sherry Pie. Okay, what do I do now? Let's say this. We found out that after, you know, everything that she did, and after season 12, that she started going to therapy and seeing, I think, a psychiatrist, and that's great. Knowing that you have a problem and that you want to fix it is great. Is that an okay answer? Does that work for y'all? Next up, Gigi Goode. Okay, Gigi is one of the smartest contestants on that show. What do I mean by that? She knew what her drag was. She had a specific style that she knew that the judges would love, and obviously that she herself, you know, liked and was able to properly transform or utilize when it came to different runway categories, which led to her having a memorable image in our heads that also is, you know, different enough from similar queens that you can be like, oh, that's Gigi Goode. But also, she went into this season telling us in the confessionals and probably even telling the producers that she wasn't good at anything. So then whenever she would do stuff well, we would be like, oh, like really impressed, like well done, Gigi. Making us kind of root for her, but also see that she's intelligent, that she's going into every challenge knowing what the fuck is up. So yeah, props to her on that. Crystal Method. Okay, so like I said with Aiden, there's this sort of like horror-esque or like diet horror aspect to her look, which I always love. I also love how Crystal Method knew how to use her out of drag look to entice RuPaul into getting her through the competition. That's very smart, very clever. We gotta give her props for that. It's maybe not the most original drag name ever, but I always love a pun drag name. Crystal Method, haha, funny, sure, why not. And she has my favorite look from season 12 with her Freddy Krueger look from, what was it, episode 1? Yeah, she was in the first group of queens, which will always give you points in my book. And lastly, for season 12, let's talk about the winner, the legend herself, Jaida Essence Hall. I will die on this hill of defending her win, saying that she needed to win that season, not for anything outside of the, you know, drag race, real world life stuff happening. Did that influence it? Maybe like 5% of it did. The rest of the, you know, the 95% was just her being fucking amazing at everything. Think of a challenge on that season and think of how Jaida did there. She did well. Like, the only time that she kind of messed up, quote unquote, was in that stand-up thing, but that episode had so many problems, we're not gonna talk about it now. We're here to praise Jaida Essence Hall, legend. Throughout the season, we're like, oh no, this is a dorky queen that's really fun and that knows how to do comedy, that knows how to do looks, that knows how to do looks that aren't just like classic drag, but also something more modern, like a modern take on classic drag, which is kind of an interesting mix. She's the deserving winner of this season. Stan Jaida Legend Hall.